In the previous slide, you have learned about the different patterns that you can use as a wildcard to refer to files in a bash shell environment. You can use globbing with any command that refers to files on your computer. But in this lesson, you will see how it works when used with ls. And at the same time, it teaches you some of the ls basics as well. So let's start by typing cd/etc to go into the etc directory. This directory contains many different files, which makes it a good candidate for our globbing demo. As there are so many files on Linux, you might not always remember the last part of a file name. If that happens, just replace it with a star. lshost*, for example. Or, if you aren't sure about the first part either, put an asterisk in there as well, as in lshost*. Which basically looks for all files that have the text host somewhere in their name. As you can see, it doesn't only give us the names of files, it also gives us the name of a directory. In some cases, that can be annoying. Another example is when we do lsp*, just to get a list of all the files that have a name that starts with p. Well, as you can see, it's not just files, there are many directories that start with P as well, and the default behavior is that ls shows us the entire contents of the directory. To prevent this from happening, type ls -dp*. It just gives you the names of the directories and not their contents. Now, something that's also very useful for globbing is a question mark. What do you think, for example, of ls?*st*? This would show files that have st on the third and the fourth position. And directories with a matching name as well, but again, you can use -d if you just want to see the names of the directories and not their contents. If you're not sure how to write a file name, you can put different letters between square brackets. As in lshost*, which gives you all files that start with either host or most. Now that we're talking about square brackets, between square brackets you can also put a range. As in ls*0-9*, for example. This gives you the names of all the files and directories that have a number somewhere in their name, which might be useful. The last thing that may be useful when working with square brackets is the exclamation mark, which gives an exclusion. For example, let's do ls -d to prevent us from seeing directories, and between the square brackets, ABCD. Which can of course be written as A-D as well, because it's a series of letters, followed by a star. This shows all files and directory names unless the name starts with an A, B, C or D.